Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to my lowest calorie kitchen where we make amazing recipes low in calories, high in volume and high in protein so you can lose weight, maintain your weight and reach your overall fitness goals. Christmas is upon us, I'm wearing my favorite Christmas t-shirt with the two reindeer and the little T-Rex following them which oddly enough looks strangely like the one on Chrome when you don't have an internet connection. So anyway, I know you don't have the time right now to try out a new recipe because of all your Christmas chores. But you will have enough time for this one, because it only takes 5 minutes to make. So take a break from what you're doing right now and let's make the lowest calorie no-bake chocolate cake. So just as last time, we'll be starting out with some coffee. And a bit of Christmas magic. So I've already measured out what we need for this recipe and it goes as follows. 30 grams of whey protein, 45 grams of casein protein powder, 30 grams of coconut flour, 30 grams of ground oats. Those are just regular oats I use the food processor on to make them a finer texture. 30 grams of your favorite sweetener, I use a stevia based sweetener, 50 grams of dark cocoa powder, 120 ml of skimmed milk and a small pinch of salt. Now the two protein powders we're going to be using for this recipe are whey and casein. There are a few points I need to make regarding protein powders and cooking. Casein protein powder is better suited for cold recipes as it will absorb a lot of humidity, a lot of liquid. It will provide a drier, grittier texture, while whey protein will not absorb so much liquid and it will provide a gooier texture, like the one that sticks to your teeth more. So what I have found is that using both of them will provide the best of both worlds. If you use just one or the other, you will need to adjust the quantity of liquid you use because casein absorbs more liquid than whey. That is the biggest difference between the two. Okay, let's begin mixing them up. We'll be using a stainless steel bowl. I prefer them for obvious reasons. And since it's Christmas, we'll be using a little Christmas tree shape to mold our cake. Let's start by adding the dry ingredients. It's already beginning to smell amazing. We'll add just a pinch of salt. And you may be wondering why salt. Salt enhances the sweetness in every cake, in every sweet recipe. It is very commonly used in all of the restaurants and food places. Once we're done with the dry ingredients, it's time to add the liquid. So we'll slowly add, just a bit at a time, and make sure not to add too much. Okay, so we'll be using all of it. You will get a pump from this workout. Okay, that seems to be done. This is the consistency you want, not too dry but not too wet either. We'll be moving it to our Christmas tree shape. And there we have it. A little Christmas tree cake. Now for the bummer. It needs to stay in the freezer for about 30 minutes. So we'll be back once the 30 minutes are over. Okay, so the moment of truth is here. Let's get it out of the freezer. And this is what it looks like. Let's just get a plate and get it out of the mold. since it's Christmas, you can get a little bit festive and add a few sprinkles on it. That is a Christmas cake. That looks delicious, guys. Even smells great. So the macros for this whole thing are 590 calories, 36 grams of carbs, 16 grams of fat, and 68 grams of protein. This has 270 grams. It's a lot to eat in a whole sitting. So you know I like to compare my low-calorie recipes to the real deal, to the store-bought cake. So let's compare my low-calorie recipe to one bought from the store in a similar style. This is what you get for 590 calories. That's 140 grams. That's actually half the size of this. So my recipe has double the size and half the calories. Your choice. You choose. You can choose to eat this one or you can choose to eat this one. 590 calories, both of them. I can bet you can't eat this whole thing in one sitting. But you can eat that one, no problem. So you know my rule. If my cake tastes 80% as good as this, which is made with butter and oil and sugar and all of the goodness, then it's a win for me. So, let's give them a taste, shall we? First, we're gonna start with the real cake. That's good. That's a good chocolate cake. Now, let's try my cake. Consistency is very similar. Smell is very similar. This actually tastes better than the real one. That's amazing, guys. So really, double the volume, half the calories, and better tasting. Now that's a complete win. Gotta get another bite. So good. So good. So apart from calories and volume, as you know, my recipes are anabolic recipes, so this is full of protein, and that is full of carbs and sugars. This digests slower, that digests instantly. More calories burned through the thermic effect of food, less calories burned through the thermic effect of food. And you're sure as hell gonna eat more of that, more calories from this than from this big thing. It's a no-brainer. I choose my chocolate cake any time of the day. Going for another bite. Just too good. That's amazing. And it's really filling. I couldn't eat this whole thing. I certainly could eat that whole thing. So there you have it. Another low calorie, high volume, anabolic recipe so you can lose weight or maintain your weight in an enjoyable way without eating boring food, without having to sacrifice taste, so you can enjoy life and enjoy Christmas. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this content, please subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification icon. Let me know in the comment section below if you gave it a try and give this video a like if you did. Please watch my two other videos linked here. And until next time, Merry Christmas, everyone.